From a bar where the only attraction isn't the beer and a bridge that you really don't want to walk over, here are the top 5 haunted places in Texas that you should never visit, part 2. Number 5 on this list is Woman Hollering Creek. The Woman Hollering Creek is a very scary and haunted place located very close to San Antonio. It's haunted by a very dangerous ghost of a woman. The legend says that a woman who was in a horrible marriage, one where her husband would sadly abuse her, started to lose her mind. She fell into a deep depression and in the creek that we're looking at, drowned her. She did this right before she took her own life as well, making it one of the saddest tragedies in this region's history. Well, it seems that her spirit never actually moved on. Her ghost is believed to regret what she did and how it all happened and can't find peace. Her regret manifests itself in a very sick and scary way though. She misses her children, and it's believed that if a child is by the bank, she will grab them and bring them down to the bottom of the creek with her to be her friend. Sadly, as you may have guessed, this doesn't go well for whoever was taken. This is why parents warn their children about going near this place without their supervision. It's very likely that this legend is just a tale made up by parents to scare their kids into staying by their side. But considering the potential consequences, I wouldn't want to take the risk. Number 4 on this list is La Carafae. Most times, bars are a sanctuary. In fact, in the entirety of the time that I've been hosting on this channel, I don't know if I've ever talked about a haunted bar before. Hard to get a place haunted when everybody that goes there is usually drinking and having a good time. A haunted bar is exactly what we have with this entry though. Thrillist says, some bars have that special, boozy charm that keeps the wine flowing and customers returning. For La Carafae, however, their popularity lies within their infamous ghost sightings and architectural ode to the French Quarter. Built in 1847, this bar is said to be the oldest pub in the downtown Market Square district. Every inch of the cozy nook sports an eclectic history, from the numerous black and white photographs on the walls to the tales of important figures such as Sam Houston being a regular guest there. And considering this building's antiquated age, it's no surprise that a couple of phantoms also call this place home. Among the rumored residents is a former bartender named Carl, who still clocks in for his shift and keeps an eye on the establishment, especially on the second floor, which is reportedly vacant after closing time. Customers have also reported glasses breaking, hearing heavy footsteps and eerie bangs, and sensing cold spots in the bathroom. This is definitely a weird one because nobody really knows why this place is as haunted as it is. Like, yes, the bar owner kind of makes sense, but from my reading, he didn't die in an unusual or tragic way by any means, just a normal passing. I suppose the good thing here is that these spirits don't seem to be particularly aggressive, and if I could just get a drink with some ghosts without fearing for my life, then, I mean, that'd be pretty cool. However, ghosts are unpredictable to say the least, and I'm sure that there are plenty of other bars in Houston that aren't haunted where you could grab a beer. Number 3 on this list is the Driskill Hotel. This hotel is located in Austin and has a very haunted history. Thrillist says, you might not think the Driskill is haunted based on its clean and recently renovated interior or its brief, stunning appearance on AMC's Texas-brimmed drama, The Sons, but it's loaded with plenty of stories that keep even the most adventurous guests running from these historic halls. Consider the girl who fell to her death down the grand staircase. The brides who killed themselves in the bathtub of the same room exactly 20 years apart, and the reports of Colonel Jesse Driskill checking on his hotel, cigar still lit in his mouth. These spirits have haunted many people throughout the years of this hotel's operation. So many reports of sightings and feelings of presences have been had. Lots of people say that they'll feel someone over their shoulder, touching their hair, or a hand on their back, but when they turn around, they don't see anything at all. A few rooms in particular have had some stark temperature changes happen to them, so much so that people have had to request to change rooms because it got so cold. Some people have even reported seeing an orb of light floating around the stairwell, never getting close enough to a person for them to touch it, but seemingly tempting them with its presence. This is your classic haunted hotel, and it checks all the boxes as being one of the most haunted spots in Texas. Number 2 on this list is the AI Engineering Building. Now, these days, when somebody says AI, you automatically think of artificial intelligence, but that's not actually what this AI stands for. It actually stands for Animal Industries. Texas Highways says, in 1959, Roy Simmons, foreman of the meat locker in Texas A&M University's old Animal Industries building, was performing a bit of a routine butchery on a slab of bacon. As he was cutting toward himself, the knife slipped in his hand, stabbing his leg near the groin. The blade cut open his femoral artery. His assistant, who'd stepped out for a moment, returned to find him bleeding out on the floor. An ambulance was summoned, but in vain. Simmons died before he could be removed from the building. Simmons' death was a tragic accident, but it doesn't take much for a tragic accident to take on a more ghostly cast. In the daytime, we never thought much about any ghosts or strange occurrences, says Jeffrey Savile, a Texas A&M professor who was an undergrad and grad student in the 1970s. It was the nights when we were in the meat laboratory conducting research, usually by ourselves, that one would hear strange noises or feel like you weren't alone. Over the years, Savile says, students and custodians working in the bowels of the building have reported invisible footsteps, strange noises, and objects scattered far from their original resting spots. Savile attributes many of the stories to the natural spookiness of an old building and noisy machinery such as the elevator and the refrigeration compressors. A series of renovations of the building have turned the site of Sims' accident into an office space. Whether or not Sims' ghost roams the hallway, Savile says, one thing keeping his memory alive is the lesson offered by his death. It became a precautionary tale each semester as we visited with students about safety and meat cutting. It gets their attention when you tell them that somebody lost their life because of a knife accident. And I imagine it also gets their attention when his literal ghost is haunting them as they try to learn. If you're big into animal industries, then maybe look at some other schooling options before settling in on Texas A&M. And finally, number one on this list is Goatman's Bridge. Now, this bridge isn't the greatest of all time, like the name might suggest. In fact, it's probably one of the worst bridges of all time, based on how freaking haunted it is. It was built back in 1884 and initially was used as a very popular spot to move cattle across. Over the years, a tragedy struck this bridge that has it being haunted by a dark and demonic spirit. It's a sad story where a colored goat farmer was murdered by some Klansmen on this bridge many years ago. It's believed that the demonic spirit that haunts this place now is that of this goat farmer who was horribly wronged back then. Locals around this area do not go over this bridge at nighttime unless they really have to. So many sightings have happened over the years where people will go over the bridge and be met on the other side by said where people will go over this bridge and be met on the other side by this said angry spirit. He doesn't hold back against you either and will make you pay for the sins of others. Disappearances have happened at this bridge several times and people have reported being attacked but managing to get away with their lives. If it's nighttime, then do not go anywhere close to this bridge because it may actually be the last thing that you ever do. But there you have it, guys. That is our list of the top 5 haunted places in Texas that you should never visit, part 2. Please comment down below what you thought about this list and some other potentially haunted spots that I may have missed. Also, please hit the like and subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, Nicholas Playlog, and I'll catch you next time.